Good afternoon, year 9. How are you, all of you? Hope you are fine and safe at home. Well, once again, welcome to Best Montessori Distance Learning ePortal. Now, do you remember what we had done in the last class of English? Yes, we had started second chapter of the English book named as Advising and Persuading. Suggestions, Advising and Persuading. Now, in that chapter, we had finished the literature part of the chapter in which we understood the explanation of the chapter as well as we did few question answers. Now, in that chapter, we had moved on to the grammar part. In the grammar part, there is preposition. To undo that exercise of the grammar part, let us first understand this preposition. I think you all must be knowing about the preposition because already we had finished this topic in the grammar part. So today I am going to just revise this topic with you, preposition. So first of all, let us see what is a preposition. A preposition is a word that links a noun or a pronoun with other words of the sentence. That is, it creates a relationship between noun and other words of a sentence. Now these other words may be noun, verbs or adjective. So a word which develops the relationship between the noun and the other words of the sentence, that is known as preposition. These other words may be a noun, it may be a verb, or it may be an adjective. For example, a cat is sitting under the table. Now here, if I remove this word under from the sentence, what will be the sentence? A cat is sitting the table. Does this sentence make any sense? No, we don't know. A cat is sitting the table. It does not make any sense. But this, when we write this word under, it means it is telling the position of the cat, that the cat is sitting under the table. So this word under is your preposition. It is developing the relationship between this cat and the table, that the cat is sitting under the table. Here cat is also a noun and table is also a noun. So this cat noun is related with the table with the help of this preposition under. So this type of words which develop the relationship between the noun and the other words of the sentence, they are called preposition. Now let us move to the types of preposition. There are three types of prepositions. First is preposition of time. This preposition describes when an event is taking place. Whatever is happening, whatever things are happening, when those things are happening, time, as the name is indicating time. So when the event is taking place, that is described by the preposition of time. Its example are in, on, at, before, after, etc. For example, let us see a few examples. My birthday falls in the month of January. So how we can find out is simply read the sentence and ask the question when. If the sentence will give you the answer of the question when, then it means the preposition in that sentence is preposition of time. For example, now the sentence is my birthday falls in the month of January. So I will ask the question, when is my birthday? When does my birthday fall? It is giving me the answer, my birthday falls in the month of January. So it is giving the answer of when. So it means it is a preposition of time. What is a preposition here? In. So in this sentence is the preposition of time. So let us same way, second example, my vacation will end on Monday. When will your vacation end? I am asking the question when. When will my vacation end? When will your vacation end? My vacation will end on Monday. It is giving me the answer of the question when again. So it is the preposition of time. And what is a preposition here? On. So on is here the preposition of time because it is giving me the answer of when your vacation will end. It gets cold at night. When does it get cold? It is giving me the answer of when it gets cold at night. So here again at is a preposition of time. So just see the sentence and ask the question when. If the sentence will give you the answer of the question when, then it is a preposition of time. Second type of preposition is preposition of place. So same way, read the sentence and if the sentence will give you the answer where of the question where, then it means this preposition is the preposition of place. So this preposition describes where an event is taking place. Where an event is taking place. For example, under, above, at, in, on, etc. Now see, in, on, at, they are preposition of time also and they are preposition of place also. So how you will distinguish whether it is preposition of time or preposition of place? Simply by asking the question when and where. If the sentence is giving you the answer of when, then it is preposition of time. If the sentence is giving you the answer of where, then it is preposition of place. Now see the examples here. The books are on the table. Ask the question, both the questions you ask. Where are the books? It is giving you the answer of where are the books? The books are on the table. Now ask the second question. When are the books? Does it make any sense? No. So it means it is giving the answer of where are the books? The books are on the table. It is giving you the answer of where. So here on is the preposition of place. So in this way you can distinguish, because in, on and at, they are preposition of time also and they are preposition of place also. You can distinguish simply by asking the question when and where. If they give you the answer of when, then it is preposition of time. If they give you the answer of where, it is preposition of place. Second example, airplane is just below the cloud. Here, below, where is the aeroplane? Ask the question, where is the aeroplane? Airplane is just below the cloud. So it is giving you the answer of where. Again, it is a preposition of place. Now third one is preposition of direction. This preposition describes in which direction to move or where to put something. In which direction to move or where to put something. For example, to, into, of, from, etc. Let us see here again example. We went to London last week. Here the preposition is to. Which preposition is this? Is it preposition of time? No. Is it preposition of place? No. It is preposition of direction. We went to London last week. We went up the hill. Up, up. It is telling you the direction. In which direction you are moving? In upward direction. So these prepositions are the prepositions of direction. So I hope you must have understood that there are three types of prepositions. Preposition of time, place and direction. Time you will tell you the answers of the question when. Place will tell you the answers of the questions where. And direction will tell you the direction in which direction to move. Now let us see the third part of the preposition, that is a prepositional phrase. What is a prepositional phrase? It is a group of words containing the preposition. It is a group of words containing the preposition. For example, the rabbit hopped through the garden. First of all, see what is the preposition here. The rabbit hopped through the garden. The preposition is through. Now, we are not asked about the preposition. We are talking about the prepositional phrase. Phrase means a group of words. A group of words which contains the preposition. So the phrase will be here, through the garden. It is a group of words in which the preposition is contained, and which preposition is contained? Through. So therefore, through the garden is a prepositional phrase. The balloon drifted up the stairs. Here the preposition is up. Can you tell me which type of preposition is this? Up. Yes, it is preposition of direction. Very good. The balloon drifted up. But here we are talking about the phrase. Up is only the preposition. What will be the phrase? Group of words which contains the preposition. So preposition is up. So up the stairs is the group of the words which is containing the preposition up, and this up is the preposition of direction. So the group of words which is containing this preposition is up the stairs. Therefore, up the stairs is a prepositional phrase. Very simple. So phrase, a prepositional phrase is what? A group of words containing the preposition. So this was all I wanted to discuss with you about the preposition. Simply, that's just the revision of the preposition. Although you all have done the worksheet also related to this preposition, this was simply a revision so that you may recall all the things which you have done with the preposition. So for today's homework, now there is one exercise in the second chapter of your English book regarding this preposition. I will be uploading the PDF of that exercise. Please see that PDF and do it in your English 1 copy. That two exercises are there, and both the exercises are related to the preposition only. That is why I have revised this preposition phrase with you and preposition also with you. Just go through that revision. I will provide you the reading material of preposition also. Just go through the reading material of the preposition and do those both exercises of preposition in your English 1 copy. The exercises will be provided to you in the PDF file. Please download that PDF file. Okay, thank you, class.